What's going on, everybody? Everyone's having a fantastic evening, a fantastic afternoon, fantastic pre-noon. No matter where you are in the world, I'm Sean Piker, and this is the Hot Sauce Broadcast coming to you live from sunny California, Los Angeles. Folks, we're live and alive, and I hope all the boys, I hope all the girls, and I hope all the MBs are having a fantastic one, because today is a beautiful day. Today is a wonderful day. Today's a fantastic day. Today's a very special day for all of you who don't know. This is Friday. That's right. Today is fucking Friday. Ladies and gentlemen.
Plus, you know we finally here, right?
Well,
it's Friday then. It's Saturday, Sunday, what? It's Friday then.
That's right.
It's Friday, Sunday, what?
It's fucked up Friday. It's fuck a fan's mom Friday. It's flat fuck Friday. It's for all the wage cucks to feel like they have a semblance of authority, autonomy, freedom in their lives. Stay hydrated. It's 62 degrees and sunny out here in California, Los Angeles, folks. On this wonderful Friday, I think this might even be a special Friday. I think it's one where, like, is this where Jesus died or something? Is this Good Friday? Getting a half day today. Shouts out to all my Christians. Yeah, that's right. Shouts out to all my Christians. Shouts out to Jesus Christ. He was fucking peeled, okay? You know me, I always respect a man who lifts. And boy, did Jesus lift, if you know what I'm saying. Not only did he lift the world on his shoulders, lifted the weight of all of our sins, but he lifted weight in general, okay? I mean, have you seen him on the fucking cross? My man was shredded, okay? And he's not the only one who's shredded, or getting shredded, at the very least. That's right, I'm talking about your boy. Part of the broadcast where I tell you a little bit about my personal news, about what's going on in my life. And let me tell you, what's going on in my life is nothing really significant, actually. Tadek unfortunately left last night, making me cry, making me sad. It was wonderful having him here. You know, that's my brother right there. That's my little bro right there. Ironic because he's even younger than my little bro, Murat, my actual little brother. But, you know, it was great. It was great hanging out with him. But, you know, all good things gotta eventually come to a close. Oh my God, my nose hairs are getting too long. I feel like it's too... If Jesus sees his shadow on Sunday, we get 6 more weeks of spring. Ancient Christian wisdom. Wait, really? Timmy Liu news. I don't know what you want from me. Assimilation to get it to you. Anyway. What was I saying? Yeah. Tadek left. I didn't get to work out last night, but I wanted to spend some time with him, so I ended it yesterday. We were supposed to play a little bit of Valo together, but we didn't do that because he was feeling bad, because I think I fucking dunked on him too hard. I'm just kidding. I don't know what happened, but he was a little sick. Could have been the fact that I did actually force him to do a bunch of physical stuff that he normally wouldn't do, you know what I mean? Or maybe he just didn't feel comfortable. He might have had, you know, I don't know. He just didn't want to be on, he didn't want to stream. He did have a headache, yeah. I don't know why, but I do legitimately believe that it could be because I was like, making him work out in ways that he hasn't before, you know what I mean? That's gaming kryptonite. It's true. I do have a bowling shirt on. I know. I have a bowling shirt on. It's the Godzilla bowling shirt. It's the new Teddy Fresh Godzilla bowling shirt on. Anyway. Would you ever consider doing a wardrobe stream? Really like your style, dude? Bro, you're crazy if you think I would do a wardrobe stream. That's so much drama. Thank you for saying that, but I'm gonna keep it real with you. If I, you know, if I went and did a clothing thing, that would, you know, everyone would go fucking crazy because it's such a subjective thing. Like every time I post, anytime I go viral, there's like thousands of people that are just like, bro, you went to a brothel, which means you do sex trafficking, you know what I mean? And clothing is like one thing that everyone, because it's so subjective, everyone can shit on it no matter how fly a fit is. And like the reality is that like some of my fits aren't great either. So that would be awful. That would be an awful, awful thing to do. It sucks, but look at that. There's already this. Teddy Fresh, USD $95. So, I have some good news. Woke up early this morning and I went to work out. And let me tell you, $100 USD for a t-shirt. No, it's not. It's not a t-shirt. It's a bowling shirt. It's a button-up shirt and it's a nice one. Also, the reality is that it's actually not $95 for me. It was fucking $0 for me. Yeah, I got it for $0 because it's my co-host and his wife, mainly, that design and make these. I don't know if you know this. So I get this shit for free $99, baby. But yeah, I actually texted Ethan last night telling him like Ela really fucking popped off big time with this one, because like you guys already know I'm fascinated with like Japanese fashion, but especially the parachute pants that she made. That's exactly what I was looking for. So I'm incredibly stoked. Do you think that's what Japanese people wear? No, not the bowling shirt. The parachute pants is like not Japanese fashion, but fashionable Japanese people wear it. Like there is no such thing as like, it's just that there's international fashion and Japanese people are all over it. Okay. That's it. But as far as, you know, as far as the parachute pants goes, like, this is some fucking Harajuku ass shit right here. And I think these are fire. I literally told Ethan, I was like, bro, Ela really popped off on this. These parachute pants are so sick. They're so perfect. They're so comfy. They're so cozy. And he said that was like, he said that this was like, a high-end one that they were a little bit worried people might not react positively to, but they're sick. I love the silhouette. Bro, your chat is proving your initial point. You can't talk fashion here. Yeah, it is very, it is like JNCO jeans, early 2000s, Y2K. That's how it is. But that's like what's popping currently. Yes. It's both simultaneously 90s wear and Y2K as well. It was great. It's very sad because I love fashion. The community always cries about it. But that's the point. It's very subjective. So, like, it doesn't matter. When you're doing stuff like that, it's just, there's always going to be differences in opinion. As long as people keep it civil and they don't go, oh, dude, you're wearing this because you're, like, a pedophile or whatever, I don't really care. You know what I mean? Which people still end up doing, you know what I mean? Like, motherfuckers act like I'm wearing some Goo Goo Gaga ass outfits, you know what I mean? It's just, like, normal, dog. I'm wearing some normal ass shit. Shut the fuck up. It also varies on where you go. You're in a tier one fashion city. A lot of us live in a place where Patagonia and Montclair is considered high fashion. Yeah, no. Did you see Tate's recent tweets disparaging women doing thirst traps? Yes, dude, I did. Bro, he's just trying to desperately cling back to relevance now that he's out of prison and in house arrest, under house arrest. Wait, hold up. Prosecution considering charge against YouTuber shot during the video prank? Oh my God, I was right. Oh my God, I told you. Oh my God. As soon as I saw that it was a fucking prank, YouTuber, I was like, hold up. What was the prank? And we tried to fucking find what the prank was. And we couldn't find what the prank was, which I thought was, like, relatively suspicious that no one was talking about what the prank was. And they were like, oh, no, it's just, like... You know what I mean? But who knows? It might just be, like, a minor thing. Anyway, regardless, I didn't even get to the fucking... I didn't even get to, like, the main point here. Wait, how do you download a GIF? Blast off fan art. I don't know how to download this GIF off of Twitter. No, you can't right click save as. You can only copy GIF address. Bro, why are you saying right click save as? Look. What the fuck do you mean? Why is chat like this? Okay, I can do it on Twitter. Let's see, maybe it'll work this way. No, it just opens it the same tweet. Y'all are so whack for this. Chat is just as boomer as I am. Suck my dick, chat. Anyway, it doesn't matter. All right, we got plenty. We got plenty to fucking tweet out. So, anyway, the last thing I was going to say is I worked out this morning and, you know, I had a pretty good fucking session. And I am, again, another week of good diet. And I'm 249. I'm almost 248. So, cracking at it. And I think like a couple weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, I'll definitely hit 245, which was my midterm goal. I'm getting closer and closer to my final goal of achieving 230 pounds. which is when I will most likely start doing, you know, more shirtless shit. But yeah, it's exciting. What is this? Small boy sad Hassan hasn't found a dog yet. I have found a dog. I just can't get her yet because she's too young.
Okay, so it looks like you killed him. Melon. It looks like you killed him. What happened to him?
Oh my god, this dog is so fucking cute. Dead.
I've never seen a dog so chill. So when I met him, was at a party in a house for my pets. Okay, so it looks like you killed him, Melon.
This has nothing to do with the fucking, I don't get it.
I've never seen a dog so chill. So when
I don't understand. This has nothing to do with me. What the fuck? Why'd you clip this? I mean, I know why you clipped it. Rory V! Thank you for the 25 gifted subs, my friend. Bonded with my Chem Lab partner over your stream, certified per moment. Yeah, I talked to a my trainer has like a little bro, not like an actual younger brother, but like a little bro program, and he's now 16. And I feel like the last time I saw him, he was like 14. And, like, he was, like, a little baby, and he's grown so fucking much, it blew my goddamn mind. Seeing him, like, seeing him over the course of, like, 2 years become this, like, dude, you know what I mean? 14 to 16, he just, like, became a guy, which is cool to see. But also, you know how 16-year-olds are. They're fucking shitheads, okay? And, like, he's still a bit intimidated by me. So he's not going to like openly talk shit. You know what I mean? But he's now like, so slowly, like, you know, he's got Instagram. So he's like looking at Instagram reels and shit like that. You know what I mean? And he was telling me like, you know, oh, I got a lot of friends who are fans of yours, but then I got a lot of friends who are not fans of yours at all. And I was like, oh, I know who those guys are. So I was asking him like, who do they watch? And, you know, it's all fucking, all fucking like Aiden Ross fans and Tater Tots. Yeah. Oh, brother. The Tater Tots are out there, especially under the age of like 20. There are so many fucking, imagine when that happens and it's your own kids. No shot. That is not happening. There's no way. Does he watch You Are Aiden or Nobody? Bro, he's 16. He doesn't watch anything. He just like sees reels. That's it. He sees reels on Instagram. He sees shorts on YouTube. It's the same as my cousin. My cousin doesn't watch a particular content creator. I feel like watching a particular content creator nowadays is like old people shit. If you're 16, if you're 14, if you're younger than that even, you don't watch a content creator. You just see them on your newsfeed pass by 15 seconds at a time. Like, younger generations, like I'm talking Generation Alpha, right? Isn't that what it is? Like, younger than Zoomers even, they don't watch things. Like, to them, it's like watching fucking the director's cut of The Lord of the Rings. If you want to watch, like, a 15-minute YouTube video from a particular content creator, they're like, no. Not happening. I don't have time for that. On God, give me this in a fucking, you know, give me this with some Subway Surfers on the side. For real, for real. I don't have the attention span. Then there are the fucking freaks, like Zoomers that are in here who are just like spending all their time, you know, watching me and shit. Which, or anyone else really for that matter, or even XQC, like, remember, at least a lot of you Zoomer freaks that are watching me, I'm giving you fucking news, right? Then there are plenty of Zoomers out there that just like sit there and watch, you know, Minecraft speedruns and shit like that, or whatever XQC is doing, whatever Forsen is doing. And, you know, those guys are not necessarily the normies of the class. The normies of the class, as far as I understand, are people that are, you know, are kids that are just basically watching TikTok, watching Instagram, that kind of shit. I remember hearing boomers talk about millennials killing our attention spans with Cliff and Sparks notes. Yeah. But, you know, we will look at Bud Light Hogwatch controversies today. Hold on. Hogwatch Bud Light edition. Ukraine plan leaks, which I think is like weird. I don't know how the fuck they let that shit get into the media. I don't know what's going on there. I'll be real with you. Shit is like very, it's very quiet in here while I'm writing. Okay. Please tell me we'll be covering the Tennessee explosions. No, I refuse to cover it because I'm keeping it a secret. Don't ask me about Biden administration's Title IX. Don't ask me about the Tennessee expulsions. Absolutely no coverage. I'm going to keep it a secret. That's between you and I. Okay? Yeah, and of course, definitely not covering Al-Aqsa either. Definitely not covering Palestine either. It's like every single thing that you guys have brought up, I have talked about extensively yesterday. Okay? For hours and hours and hours. I did it. Go look at the VOD from yesterday. You know what I mean? I don't know what to tell you. But we will still cover it today. You know, but we're going to also have some fun today, too. It's also in my title. Clarence Thomas and more, get in now. It's can you talk about One Piece? Yes, I can. I'm in the post Marine Fort arc where like it's basically a flashback going deep diving into like Ace's relationship with Luffy. And the introduction of a new character. Not going to give you too many spoilers on that. Introduction of multiple characters, but one that I assume is going to be very important in the upcoming arcs. Yeah, Kid Piece, which is very good, actually. At first, I thought it was going to be not that good. You know, I was like, oh, what the fuck? Who gives a shit? Why are we covering this now? You know, why are we getting back into this now? But it's actually very good. It's very, very good. And I'm enjoying it so far. Obviously, there is a profound amount of like class politics, baked within it. I wouldn't say it's like, you know, materialist. Or I wouldn't say it's dialectical materialism, but it certainly showcases like the most liberal in a very liberal way. It showcases like ruling class, the elites, a city with multi layers. There's always a god above you. You know, you have the celestial dragons above the king, and underneath the king are the nobles. But the nobles lord over the regular, you know, upper middle class, and then the upper middle class lord over the working class, the poor, and, you know, the lumpen proles, as a matter of fact, you know, the degenerates, right? And then last but not least, you have like the untouchables. It's basically like a caste system that exists pretty much everywhere. And it goes through that. There is also a minor dragon update slash, you know, like a little bit of a additional dragon lore in there, which I love, obviously. Big dragon fan myself so far. So that's also exciting. And then you experience the cruelty of the Celestials one more time. And it's a great arc so far. Anytime I get a little bit of, you know, Monkey D. Dragon updates from the lore, I get excited. I feel like the revolutionaries are going to be the coolest so far. Like, everything I've seen thus far, the revolutionaries have been fucking incredible. But yeah, on that note, let's blast off. That's my One Piece